Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to try to do a quick and efficient video review of the Skypad 3.0. This video is long overdue. I've just been really behind on uploads and work, and of course taking care of my new baby boy Miles. So this is also a highly requested video, but today is also an important day because this is still hands down my favorite mousepad. The 3.0 just takes everything and pushes it a step further. I own over 15 plus mousepads and I have not gone back to cloth pads. Most know I reviewed the 2.0 Skypad and I purchased that one. I was sent this one just for transparency. Skypad heard I liked the 2.0 and they sent me the 3.0. But let's discuss some of the better things about the 3.0. Number one, it's thinner. This helps so it doesn't feel as raised when you're aiming. Some people mentioned that they kind of felt uncomfortable. I personally didn't mind it. And also, it does not impact how sturdy the mousepad feels. Even though it's thinner, it still feels extremely sturdy. It's also much larger than the 2.0. Definitely much larger, and the much bigger space is definitely appreciated. It has a more controlled surface as well. That's the third point. The surface it doesn't feel like you're skating as much. It's got a little bit more resistance, but it's still consistent. So I want to highlight that, the difference between the 2.0 and 3.0. At one point, I'm going to highlight this on my raw impressions, that I felt like I was going to go back to the 2.0, but I stuck with it, and I actually prefer the 3.0. Also, it's quieter. Let's segue real quick to some audio and do my best to pick it up on the microphone. This microphone is designed to make sure not to pick up background noise. It'd probably be better if I use a Blue Yeti. But I want to see if I can try to pick it up on this microphone best I can. I'm going to really bang the G303 against the mousepad, the 2.0 and the 3.0, so you can tell the difference. All right, what I'm testing here is the audio from the Skypad 2.0 with the G303. Now we're going to do the audio with the 3.0. So the biggest thing you can notice right away is that it dampens a lot more. That's the biggest difference. Now I want to highlight as well is that the packaging came in beautifully. It was an amazing presentation. I just was overall impressed. Now in the background, you probably saw quite a bit. I've been showcasing my grid shot score I got today, literally moments before recording. The reason I'm highlighting this is because since I warmed up to this mousepad, I'm always able to hit 100K. Took a little bit to get used to the consistency of the mousepad, but every single day, I never drop below that score. I mean, I do until I get warmed up, but before it was always hit or miss. Some days it was almost impossible to do so. But the reason I'm showcasing this in the background is because the hard surface, I guess it just helps me have a consistent surface. The surface will not and has not changed over time for me. And I'm a big heavy user myself, and this also helps my overall aim and accuracy. For aimers like me, this is honestly a true blessing. So now let's segue to the test range and let's kind of talk about this mouse a little bit more. I'm gonna let the grid shot score kind of play out, and then you're gonna hear me kind of segue to the test range midway through. So there might be a little bit wonkiness, but I want you to see the full aim lab score, which luckily is only like a minute. All right, so let's do that. Now in this video, outside of the stuff that I scripted, I really just kind of want to talk real with you guys and my honest thoughts about this mousepad. It happens to be my favorite mousepad. It's my new main driver. I don't think I'm ever going to switch to a different one just because the surface doesn't change. Very consistent, even after, I think it's been 3 weeks or 2 weeks since I have had this mouse pad, and I just absolutely adore it. It's perfect. The noise, I'll do a comparison earlier in the video with the noise, but it's definitely a lot quieter than before. The thinness actually helps a ton. It still feels extremely sturdy. It's really quick and easy to clean off. I have a micro, it's a little dirty, you can tell, but it is what it is. At the same time, I love it. It's really nice. This is, yeah, they sent me the mouse pad, but before when I did, I paid full price, right? And just to be transparent, I loved the 2.0. I honestly, for a minute there, the first 3 days, I thought I was going to go back to the 2.0. I didn't actually think I was going to sit and use the 3.0. And that's also a little disclaimer for you guys, is that it takes about 2 to 3 days of actual dedication to the mouse pad to really not work it in, but just to adjust to it. It is a unique surface. There is resistance when you're moving. You can even hear it. Well, no, you guys can't hear it, but you can feel it. Excuse me. You can feel the way the glide feels. And it's super smooth. It's really nice for controlling recoil. It's great for precision shots because it's a lot more controlled than the 2.0. I'm just overall really impressed with the quality and the build of this mousepad. It just makes me feel confident that I never have to buy another mousepad. And well, maybe if anything happens with the Skypad, I'll review it in another 6 months to a year if I feel the surface has changed. But usually around this time frame, even using the GSR SE, I would have noticed right away if the surface has changed or if it feels a little different. But overall, a really, really, really impressive. It makes me more confident with my settings. For those probably asking or thinking in the comment section, yes, I'm still using raw acceleration. I'm also sticking with the G303. I'm not switching, even though I made the video in the super light. I still really prefer the G303. And for this mousepad, at least now I have my consistent factors. Now, really, all I feel like I have to do is just consistently work and improve. And every single day when I come back to it, I feel extremely consistent. So big shout out to Skypad for sending me this mousepad. I'm not switching. I love it. I own so many artisan pads. I own, you know, so many Logitech pads, everything. But this pad is just that good. I just kind of wanted to record those raw thoughts and just talk about it, because I don't really feel like recording it in a script kind of gathers my real impressions and how I really feel about it. Because sometimes when you script things, I try my best to sound authentic and real, but I really like to have a conversation with you guys and just try to address whatever questions you guys might have. Again, comment down below. Let me know your thoughts. How do we do it? And this is kind of an updated review, again, compared to the 2.0. Because the 2.0, I kind of covered a lot of that. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and I'll see you guys all in the next video.